Hello everyone, welcome to System Software and Compilers Module 3 lecture video. In this lecture, we will be learning how to eliminate the left recursion from the grammars and how to left factor the grammars. Elimination of left recursion. A grammar is left recursive if it has a non-terminal A such that there is a derivation A derives A alpha for some string alpha. Top-down parsing methods cannot handle left recursive grammars. So, a transformation is needed to eliminate left recursion. The immediate left recursion where there is a production of the form A derives A alpha. Here we see the general case how the left recursive pair of productions like A derives A alpha or beta. A derives A alpha or beta could be replaced by the non-left recursive productions without changing the strings derivable from A. So here the rule can be A derives beta A dash, A dash derives alpha A dash or epsilon. This rule by itself suffices for many grammars. Consider the expression grammar E derives E plus T or T, T derives T star F or F, F derives parenthesized E or ID. This grammar contains the left recursion. The non-left recursive expression grammar is obtained by eliminating the immediate left recursion from the expression grammar. The left recursive pair of productions are obtained for each left recursive productions. So, we need to apply the productions, the left recursion rules for each production which contains the left recursion. So, the replacement productions are A derives A alpha or beta. If the production is of this form, then we have to write A derives beta A dash or beta A dash derives, A dash derives alpha A dash or epsilon. So first we consider the first production E derives E plus T. So E derives E plus T or T. Here we need to find out A alpha and beta. So here plus T will be the alpha, E will be the A and T will be the beta. So the productions after the elimination of left recursion from this product the productions will be E derives T E dash, E dash derives plus T dash or epsilon. So in the same way, we need to eliminate the left recursion from the second production, that is T derives T star F or F. So F becomes a beta, star F becomes a alpha, T becomes A. So now we can write the non-left recursive productions like T derives F T dash, T dash derives star F T dash or epsilon. So consider the third production from the grammar, F derives parenthesized E or ID. So this grammar, this production doesn't contain the left recursion. So it is written as it is. So now this is the non-left recursive grammar for the expression grammar. Immediate left recursion can be eliminated by the following technique, which works for any number of A productions. First, we need to group the productions as A derives A alpha 1 or A alpha 2 and A alpha M or beta 1 or beta 2 and so on up to beta N, where no beta begins with an A. Then we need to replace the A productions by the productions A derives beta 1 A dash or beta 2 A dash or and so on up to beta N A dash. A dash derives alpha 1 A dash or alpha 2 A dash and so on up to alpha M A dash or epsilon. The non-terminal A generates the same strings as before, but this doesn't contain the left recursion. This procedure eliminates all left recursions from A and A dash productions, but it does not eliminate left recursion involving derivations of two or more steps. For example, consider the grammar S derives A or B, A derives A C or S D or epsilon. The non-terminal S is left recursive because S derives A derives S D A, but it is not immediately left recursive. Let us see the algorithm that systematically eliminates left recursion from the grammar. It is guaranteed to work if the grammar has no cycles or epsilon productions. Cycles can be eliminated systematically from a grammar as how we eliminate the epsilon productions from the grammar. Left recursion elimination algorithm. The algorithm works as follows. In the first iteration for I equals 1, the outer for loop of lines 2 to 7 eliminates any immediate left recursion among A1 productions. Any remaining A1 productions of the form A1 derives AL alpha must therefore have the condition L greater than 1. After the I minus 1 iteration of the outer for loop, all non-terminals that is AK where K is less than I are cleaned up. That is, any production AK derives AL alpha must have the condition L greater than K. As a result, on the ith iteration, the inner loop of lines 3 to 5 progressively raises the lower limit in any production, that is AI derives AM alpha until we have the condition M is greater than or equal to I. Then eliminating immediate left recursion for the AI productions at line 6 forces M to be greater than I. Let us consider the previous grammar, and for that grammar we apply the algorithm. The previous grammar was just derives A or B, A derives A C or S D or epsilon. Technically, the algorithm is not guaranteed to work because of the epsilon productions involved in the grammar. But in this case, the production A derives epsilon is not harmless. So we order the non-terminals S and A. There is no immediate left recursion among the S production, so nothing happens during the outer loop for I equals 1, and for I equals to 2 we have to substitute for S in A derives S D production to obtain the following productions, that is A derives A C or A A D or B D or epsilon. From this production, eliminating the left recursion gives the following grammar. S derives A or B, A derives B D A dash or A dash, A dash derives C A dash or A D A dash or epsilon. Left factoring is a grammar transformation that is useful for producing a grammar which is suitable for predictive or top-down parsing. When the choice between two alternative A productions is not clear, then we may be able to rewrite the productions to defer the decision until enough of the input has been seen that we can make the right choice. For example, if we have the two productions, a statement derives if expression then statement else statement, or if expression then statement. On seeing this input, we cannot immediately tell which production to choose to expand the statement. In general, if A derives alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2, we do not know whether to expand A to alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2. However, we may defer the decision by expanding A to alpha A dash. A to alpha A dash. Then after seeing the input derived from alpha, we expand A dash to beta 1 or beta 2. That is the left factor. The original production becomes A derives alpha A dash. A dash derives beta 1 or beta 2. Let us take one example. The following grammar is the dangling else problem. That is, S derives I E T S or I E T S E S or A. E derives B. Here I T and E stand for if then else, and capital E and S stands for conditional expression and statement. So this grammar, if we left factor this grammar, then the grammar becomes S derives I E T S S dash or A. S dash derives E S or epsilon, and E derives B. Thus we may expand S to I T S S dash on input I, and wait until I T S has been seen to decide whether to expand S dash to ES or epsilon. Of course, these grammars are both ambiguous, and on input E, it will not be clear which alternative for S dash should be chosen.